Hello, boys and girls. My name is Mike. It is 11:30 in the morning, Sunday, June 23rd. And yep, I'm in Las Vegas. There's the Aria right there. I got my room early, but judging from this view, I'm on the fifth floor. Can you tell what hotel casino I'm staying at? This is a horrible view, horrible floor, but I did mobile check-in. That'll teach me. Always go to the lobby desk so you can talk to a agent, reservation agent. Show you the room real quick. This'll help tell you where I'm at. Anybody that's familiar with these rooms. It's a small room. I mean, you got one table there, but that's it. No fridge. Lots of art on the wall, which is nice. A couple beds. I mean, I'm not concerned about the room. I've said it in the past, but got your big, tall mirror right there. Hey, that's me. Hello. And then you got your bathroom right here, which, you know, bathroom's tiny. Got just a tiny little bit of counter space. The loo and then the shower. I do like the shower, though. I like that faux red brick look. But yeah, I don't plan on spending too much time in here, so it is what it is. Oh, and then right here, you slide this big door, and there you go. Safe already locked up with money that I will eventually lose. So yeah, tell me what room I'm in, or tell me what hotel I'm in, I should say. Most of you probably already know, but yeah, always go to the lobby. Talk to a reservation agent so you can, you know, make a request for a higher floor or this or that or the other thing. Mobile check-in is not your friend. All right. It's time to start drinking. Time to start gambling. Let's get after it. See you in a bit. Look at that. I got $346 slot dollars. I got $125 in free play. That's what? $470 in gambling money? That's nice. Sitting here on Regal Riches, I haven't started playing anything yet. I'm going to look around first. Looking down here, the games aren't optimal, so I'm not going to play here, but it's nice that I got over $400 in pre-play to spend. Let's go find a better machine, shall we? I got on a Regal Link game, which is just a more adult version of Regal Riches, basically, but trying to chase down these bonuses here. 193 on the diamonds, got to hit by 200. 95 on the emeralds, got to hit by 100. So we'll see. Going through my free play, it's only 80 cents a press. But that's fine, I'm low rolling this trip big time. But here we go, I got my first White Russian of the trip with many more to come. So wish me luck, hopefully I can get one of these bonuses. There's a nice little hit on 80 cents. 555, nice. All right, if I hit anything good, I'll let you know. All right, game update. I'm burning through all of my free play. Trying to chase down these damn bonuses, which they haven't moved at all. I haven't gotten a yellow, diamond, or an emerald. But you look at the amber, it's gonna pay at 50. I only need one more of those. I've got 13 of these cash wilds, everyday wilds, if you will. That is my third White Russian. I got another one on the way. And I am a victim of a robbery. Yeah, I'll get into that a little bit later. Oh, here we go, 13. One thing cool about this Regal Link is that these wilds can have money attached to them, as you can see. And even if they don't line up on a pay line, you still get the amount of the money, which is nice. Now, granted, the line hits don't pay as much as regular Regal Riches, because you got, you know, all of these to pay for and shit, but still, I do like this variation. It's kind of fun. Although, I don't know if I'm ever going to get that diamond and emerald. I mean, I got about $120 left of all the free play I had. And like I said, I haven't received one diamond or emerald to that total. But screw it. I'm going to go through the free play. I'm going to drink some more White Russians, and we'll see what we end up with. And no sooner than I say that, it pays. 50 cash wilds. It's only 80 cents a press, so it's not going to be a big, huge bonus or anything like that. But it will add to my total, which should be a lot bigger than that. But I got screwed. Like I said, I'll elaborate a little bit later. Anyway, hang tight. I'll show you the end result. There we go. We got 12 wilds for the final spin. You can see the bonus is only at $15.15. Like I said, 80 cents a press is not going to make anyone rich. But I'm scared of Vegas when it comes to gambling. I'm not lying. I'm used to gambling at home with machines I'm familiar with. Vegas just likes to destroy me. But anyway, what am I saying? I got $170. I got $100 in, $70 profit. About $100 or so left of the free play. I'm going to spin a little bit more, but I might walk away because, like I said, that diamond and emerald, I don't think they're going to hit at all. All right, wish me luck. We'll see what happens. All right, you know I'm going to play some moolah. I can't help it. But it started with $100. 200 there and 127 on the bonus here. Kicking butt on the bonus. Look at that. 50 spins already played. I still got 42 to go, and I just re-triggered again. This bonus is paying off big time. $1.50 a press. Yeah, this is great. This kind of makes up for the shit that happened to me earlier, which I will elaborate on. Just hang tight. I'll tell you the story. It's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Sunday, January 23rd. And I'm still at MGM. I don't know how many White Russians I've had. Quite a few. Well, I'll be honest. I've had like 7 of them. Feeling pretty good, though. And I'm having some luck on one of my favorite games. Moolah. All right, hang tight. I'll be with you in a bit. Hello, boys and girls. I am standing on a broken escalator right outside the MGM Grand. It's hot out here. It's like 105 degrees. But anyway, I'm standing here so I can show you that. Look at that. The Tropicana is just being ripped apart. It's being demolished. Gonna make way for a baseball stadium like 3 years down the road. I have no idea if they're gonna like just keep taking it apart like this, or they're taking off the facade and maybe gonna implode the skeleton of it, if you will. I don't know. But look at that. I mean, you can see right through the building to the other side. And then the other tower that they have in back, same story. I mean, it's just, yeah, it's just being ripped apart. I mean, I never stayed at the Tropicana. I don't have any love for the Tropicana except for the fact that it's an old school casino, and, you know, I'm sorry to see it go, but what are you gonna do? Yeah, about 5 o'clock in the afternoon, Sunday, June 23rd, it's hella hot. It's like 106 degrees. Wicked hot. You know, you walk inside these casinos and they're all, you know, 70 degrees, air conditioned, yada yada, and you come out here and that heat hits you in the face like a goddamn brick. Oh, there you go. There's the other tower right there, stupid. The sign's still up, amazingly. Tropicana Las Vegas, but yeah, they are just ripping that building apart. Anyway, it's been a day, let me tell you. This is, I don't like to be negative. I don't like to be negative, especially about Las Vegas, because I love Las Vegas. This has been the worst. I mean, I can't even get a break with the noise, for crying out loud. This has been the worst first day in Vegas of my life. I've been here, what, 11, 12 times now? And yeah, this day has sucked all the way around, which I keep promising I will elaborate. I will elaborate later. But yeah, I've not had a very fun first day. And it's kind of soured me on my trip, and I still got 3 days to go. I will, however, persevere, because that's what I do. So, I mean, even like, I think I've said it in past vlogs, a bad day in Vegas
pretty much better than any great day anywhere else.
Man, I think I'm gonna walk over here and get a little bit closer look, as close as I can get anyway. All right, so I found a closer escalator that is out of service and not supposed to enter, but I'm entering because it's right next to the Tropicana. Nice close-up look at the destruction of the Tropicana. It's very sad. Excalibur back there. New York, New York right there. MGM Grand, which I just left. Now this intersection right here was like a world record for the most hotel rooms on one intersection. But now that the Tropicana is gone, I'm guessing they don't hold the record anymore. Too bad. Hey, you look over there. Yeah, the building is just going away. Very sad to see. Hello, boys and girls. It's about 6:30 p.m. Sunday, June 23rd. I'm up in my room having a little room service. Turkey club with some fries and condiments and pickle. Why do they always got to serve it with a pickle? How many times I got to say it? Pickles are the devil. Except for Simone Goodspeed from A Good Times Production. She's okay. All other pickles, oh yeah, they're the devil. Yeah, I got rocked today on gambling and just, oh God, it was bad. And I still need to elaborate on what happened to me, which I will do later tonight. But I'm going to chill out in my room for a while. I've got Ridiculousness there on the TV, which is basically my go-to channel whenever I'm traveling. I just turn that on and leave it running. But anyway, yeah, rocked in the gambling world today. Didn't do well. I had a bad day. My worst day in Las Vegas. My worst opening day in Las Vegas, I should say. There goes the Aria Express tram leaving Park MGM on its way to Aria and Vidar and Bellagio. It's about 8:30 at night, Sunday, June 23rd. It's still like 104 degrees out. It's crazy warm. But you got to put up with the warmth if you want to look at the lights. The Aria Tower right up there. So yeah, it's been a rough day today. This is my worst first day in Vegas of all the trips that I've taken. I alluded to earlier that I got ripped off, and I did get ripped off. I was playing the Regal Link game, and somebody behind me was winning a big jackpot, and like an idiot, I kind of turned around to look at it for all of 20 seconds. I kid you not, 20 seconds. And while my head was turned, someone cashed out my machine and took a $247 Tito out of it. $100 of those dollars, $100 were my money, and the other $147 was Wings. But in 20 seconds, someone ripped my Tito out of my machine, and all without my knowledge. Unbelievable, huh? But you live and you learn. I mean, we've all made mistakes, you know. You really got to keep your guard up when you're in Vegas, man. Don't lose your concentration, even for 20 seconds. Shit like that will happen to you. And needless to say, I've lost today. Lost, about $900? Which, at one point, I was up almost $300. So that's what, a $1,200 swing? Yeah, that's not cool. But it's all right. I got three more days to try to recoup some losses. I got quite a few plans for the next 3 days. I got, what do I got? Gonna go check out Fountain Blue, of course. I've got the Beatles Love Show at the Mirage Wednesday night. Gonna see that before it disappears. I'm gonna go pay my respects to the Mirage. What else? I don't know. My tram's arriving though, so I'm gonna hop on that thing and head over to Bellagio. I'll see you in a bit. Kind of blurry, I'm just using my cell phone camera, but that's the Rio all lit up over there. Apparently the Rio's doing a bunch of renovations. Maybe bring it back to its former glory, huh? Got the palms right over there.
I don't think I've ever been in the Rio. I walked over that way a couple, three, 4 years ago, but I don't think I ever went in. I know I haven't been in the Palms. One of these trips, I'm going to have to do that. And then there's that one over there. I'm not sure what that one is. Yet one more thing on the list of things I need to do in Las Vegas. All right, just got off the tram, headed to Bellagio. Why am I going to Bellagio? For the fountains, of course. See you in a bit.